following program is brought to you in living color on NBC.
Disney presents
The Wonderful World of Color.
From Walt Disney's Wonderful World of Color, we bring you Disneyland 10th Anniversary. Now your host, Walt Disney.
Now look pretty, Julie. You know, this is Disneyland's 10th anniversary. And I'd like to introduce Miss Julie Reams, who has been chosen as Disneyland's official ambassador this anniversary year.
How do you do?
And I must say the judges showed good judgment.
Thank you, Walt.
Julie will be representing us all over the world, and she's well qualified. She's one of Disneyland's tour guides, and this is a tour guide costume, sort of a jockey-like costume with a riding crop. And sometimes you're referred to as guest jockey, isn't that right?
Right.
Now tell me, Julie, what do you tell the people about our future plans?
Actually, I don't know too much about them, but I do know that there is a great deal of excavation going on in Disneyland. But I would like to know a lot more if I could.
You've come at the right place. This is our Imagineering department. It is here where we dream up all the future things for Disneyland. It is also here that we dreamed up the things for the World's Fair. And some of those things are coming back to Disneyland. And especially one that I'm in love with is the story of the children of the world. We call it It's a Small World. So over here, we're designing the facade for that thing when it does come back to Disneyland. I want you to meet Mary Blair.
Mary,
this is Julie Reams.
Hello, Julie.
Will you tell her what you're doing here, Mary?
We start this way, making a preliminary sketch. Then we make a model to scale, and that's what we're doing here.
This is a half-scale model, isn't it, Mary?
It's a half inch.
One half inch represents a foot. Mm-hmm. So actually, when the thing is really built at Disneyland, those towers will be 60, 70 feet high.
That's right. Before we paint it, we use lights. See what it does?
Mm-hmm.
Well, from that, we get an idea of the kind of lighting we want at night, because this is one of the few that we've ever designed to really give a real treatment at night. Now we're going into the night lighting effects, and a lot of that will be translucent with light coming through and lights moving all across it. It'll be beautiful, like a piece of jewelry, we hope.
I'm sure it will.
Yeah, well, thank you, Mary. We got a lot of other things to see.
Bye.
Now, here's another way of going about a project. This is a 1/8 inch to a foot scale model of the new restaurant that we're putting in. We call it the Plaza Inn. It's right off the plaza. And it's going to be a period restaurant, a period about 1880, 90, with beautiful interiors and a solarium and all of that. And the people can come in here, get their food, they can eat inside, or they can go out and sit in the garden. They can sit there and watch people and enjoy themselves, and the food's going to be very good, too. Now, this is Harriet here.
Hi,
happens
Harriet.
To be putting in the little umbrellas and the tables for the scale model. Actually, this is the size of people right there. That's a people.
See?
Now, over here, we get another view of it. This is Johnny Hinch, who's in charge of this particular project.
Hi, Johnny.
Hi, Julie.
You've met before. Well, wonderful. He gets around, you know. He knows all the pretty girls. Johnny, will you explain to Juliet what we're doing here, what this is all about?
Yes, Julie. This is a more detailed model of the Plaza Inn. Now, over here is the serving area. And as you select your food, you can see through the dining room to a large solarium at the end.
And here's the beautiful solarium. Tell them about that. Get down and take a peek
this
in there.
This is another view of the dining area.
I can see it's going to be very lovely.
And through the arches, to your left, you can see this large, beautiful aviary.
With birds, singing birds, canary birds, finches in that beautiful cage, and live plants and things.
It's going to be very beautiful.
Sounds like a wonderful place to eat.
It is. You mean you have breakfast, lunch, dinner, and Johnny, just be sure it looks as good as the model, huh? Thanks.
All right, Joe.
Mark, I want you to meet Julie Ream. Mark Davis.
Very nice to meet you.
Julie is Miss Disneyland Tencennial. And Mark Davis is the master in charge of our House of Illusions, or what do we call it?
A Haunted Mansion.
Haunted Mansion and Supernatural.
Oh, lots
Can
of supernatural.
You give me a little idea what we're going to have in there?
Yes, well, we're doing a lot of portraits that change right in front of your very eyes. And a matter of fact, one of our paintings here is based on Greek mythology. This is Medusa, is a very beautiful girl. She offended the goddess Athena. And as a result, Athena turned her into a Gorgon. And as you may know, if you looked at a Gorgon would turn you into stone.
Well, we sure don't want that to happen. What does, tell her about this thing here, will you, Mark?
Well, this is our elongating, stretching room. And in this room, we also have some stretching portraits. Perhaps you'd like to look at those over there. These are some that we're using.
Pull them down. You should see what happens when the room gets longer, you get this full-size portrait. This is my favorite here.
Oh.
Now, come on, let me get a picture here. Another picture right about there. That's it. Have you seen enough? You want to see some more? We got a lot of stuff.
Oh, let's see some more.
I think we better get out of here. I think we're being watched anyway.
Good idea.
Roland, I want you to meet Julie Reams. She is Miss Disneyland Tencennial. This is Roland Crump, who for the project here is sort of acting as the interior decorator of a house of illusion. What do we call it?
Museum of the Weird.
Museum of the Weird. Will you tell her about some of these things, Roland?
These are going to be collected from all over the world, supposedly. And we're going to have man-eating plants. And we're going to have a coffin clock here that we're working on right now. We have a gypsy cart that comes to life with ghosts inside of it. We have a candleman. These are just things that are collected from all over the world. Just the weirdest things we could find.
Yeah, we're also collecting real ghosts to bring here. You believe in ghosts, don't you, Julie?
No.
You don't?
Not really.
Well, let me take you over here and convince you that they do exist. Now, you peek right in this little thing here, and then you tell me what you see. Now, peek in there. What do you see?
An organ.
What's going on?
It's playing.
Yes.
A ghost.
A ghost is playing, sure. What kind of a ghost?
A skeleton ghost.
Yeah, well, we have all kinds of ghosts, you know. Okay. Now you believe, I hope.
Huh? I have to.
I'll come right over here and I'll show you where you're going to meet the ghosts. This is a little scale model now of the Disneyland area. You've seen this many times, but we haven't got the ghosts in there yet. But we're out collecting the ghosts. We're going to bring ghosts from all over the world. And we're making it very attractive to them, hoping, you know, they'll want to come and stay at Disneyland. So we're putting in wall-to-wall cobwebs, and we guarantee them creaking doors and creaking floors. Now, that big hole that you talked about earlier, well, this is what's going to go in that big hole. This is what we call New Orleans Square. And here's a picture of it from the riverfront as it will look when it's finally finished. And all these little streets are going to be very intriguing, little shops and things. And people can wander around in there. And then in here, we have a special attraction. We call it the Blue Bayou Lagoon. And people are gonna get on a boat here and ride through the lagoon. And then as they get around here, we're gonna take them down a waterfall and take them back into the past, into the days of the pirates, you know, where the whole Caribbean area was full of pirates and they're always sacking towns and things. And you believe in pirates, of course.
Oh, yes.
Oh, you want to see some?
Love to.
Right over here. We'll meet them. Blaine, I want you to meet Julie Green.
Hello, Blaine.
Julie is Miss Disneyland Tencennial. And I want you to tell her all about what you're doing here.
We're working on a full-scale pirate, Julie. And I'd like you to have a look at him here.
Quite an angry-looking fellow.
Well, he has to be a tough guy. The pirates were pretty tough.
This will animate when we have it in the show, you know. He'll talk and And we'll have all kinds of body movements and things. They carry on a regular little story, you know.
Then he'll be audio animatronic.
Audio animatronic, that's right.
Good.
She's sharp.
She sure is.
But before Blaine does the full scale, he works on the miniatures. And then we got them right over here. Take a look at some of them. I take this little miniature here is taken first from a sketch. We make these sketches to figure out the types and the characters, and then Blaine takes them and puts them in dimension. Okay. Isn't he a handsome one?
Quite real.
Now, these sketches here have to do with some of the things that are going to happen when you take this cruise through the pirate's domain. Here's one here. Here's a pirate laden with loot. He's trying to escape. He's got one foot on the dock and one foot on a rocky boat. You know, as the people go by, they see him. He's struggling and everything.
Good luck to him.
Well, he can't make it, or the show would go to pieces, you see. He has to stay there all the time and keep trying to get away. Now we'll go around and see the town that the pirates are sacking. It's right over here. Claude, meet Julie Reams.
Hello, Claude.
She's Miss Disneyland Tencennial, and Claude is the Imagineer in charge of the pirate project. So will you explain what all this is about?
Well, we've been restaging this walking the plank scene, Walt. And with the shark circling below, we've got this fellow in a real precarious situation.
I feel quite sorry for your victim there.
Yes, he's in a bad way.
Thanks. I'm going to take Julie through the town.
Okay, Walt.
Now, over here, Julie, is the town. This is a Caribbean town of the period, and here are the pirates in here ransacking and carrying away loot and everything. As you get down here and look through that little ring, you get the view that the audience gets. Now, here you see the pirates are dunking the mayor into the well, trying to force him to reveal the hiding places of the town treasure. The audience will be seeing this from a boat, you know, and all the characters will be life-size and lifelike in their movements. These fellows have found the town's rum supplies, but they're actually more interested in what's taking place across the river. Here, their shipmates are auctioning off the town beauties, and there's the biggest bargain of all.
That is absolutely fantastic.
Well, that's only part of it. I got a big climatic scene.
But how could you top it?
Well, we set the place on fire, and we have our audience trapped down in this flaming city.
Now, how can they get out then?
Well, now you got into this mess by going down a waterfall. Now, how would you suppose we'd get them out of there?
By going up the waterfall?
That's right. Anything's possible in Disneyland. Well, here we are, back where we started. And we have about 10 seconds to get down to Disneyland for the big anniversary celebration. You think we can make it?
If we have some help.
Tink! Tink, how about putting your pixie dust to work and getting us down to Disneyland in 5 seconds? All the characters of the Magic Kingdom are gathering for the 10th anniversary celebration. There's Mickey and the whole gang. Three little pigs and guess who? Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. Pinocchio and those two rascals, Foulfellow and Gideon. Cinderella, Thumper and Flower. And the newest member of our Disney family, Mary Poppins. From now on, no Disneyland celebration is going to be complete without Mary Poppins. Hey!
as lucky can be. Chim chimney, chim chimney, chim chim cheroo. Good luck will rub off when I shake hands with you. Or blow me a kiss, and that's lucky too.
It's traditional at every Disneyland celebration to have a parade down Main Street. And there aren't many main streets left where you can see a parade. Boys and girls from the high schools in Anaheim go all out for these events, especially when they get the day off from school.
It seems like only yesterday that Disneyland was just an idea and some plans on paper. My, what a pretty dress, Julie.
Thank you, Walt. This is my Disneyland hostess dress.
And the little,
And my official pin.
Your badge.
Right.
Want to see mine? I'm number one, Secret Service. As I was about to say, here's a recent aerial photograph of Disneyland. Now, a little over 10 years ago, this whole area was just an orange grove and some farmhouses. And you couldn't have been over 8 years old at that time.
Actually, I was about 10.
The secret is out. Well, let me show you what's happened since you were 10 years old. In fact, we'll go a little farther back than that, to the time when I was pacing this place off.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Took a lot of pacing. It was over 200 acres. We built this tower so we could see the entire project, sort of a bird's eye view of our progress. After the orange grove was cleared and the houses moved, we had to carve out the hills and riverbeds. The orange trees made way for more exotic foliage from other lands. The Jungle Ride was one of Disneyland's original projects, and here we are now taking the exploratory cruise. The rails were laid around the perimeter of the park, and the E.P. Ripley given a trial run. The tracks paralleled the Frontierland River, and we had a fine view of the Mark Twain on her shakedown cruise. Sleeping Beauty's castle and Fantasyland, of course, were part of the original construction, as was Main Street. Our next big building project was in 1959. There's the start of the Submarine Lagoon and the pylons to hold the monorail. If you want anything done right, you've got to do it yourself. Was another part of this expansion program. On the gala celebration of the completion of the project, the Richard Nixon family were on hand to snip the ribbon. Here we were with our monorail, the forerunner of rapid transit of the future, all checked out and ready to go, but somebody forgot to check out the scissors. Oh, to heck with it. If you can't cut it, break it. Right. Disneyland's monorail system was a first in America, and it has already traveled close to 500,000 miles. Our Matterhorn was scaled for the first time on its inauguration. Since then, during the vacation months, climbing it has become a daily event. There is a safer and just as thrilling means of descent, and that is by taking the bobsled ride. There's the Shah of Iran and his pretty empress in the front seat, and Walt Disney and the pretty hostess in the back. To the depths. Prince Bernhard of the Netherlands is joining the passengers on our submarine cruise. It's the 8th largest submarine fleet in the world. Ranks next to Turkey, I think. Next step in our growth was to make the mine train ride longer and more exciting. Ike and Mamie Eisenhower and grandchildren were among the first guests on this trip through rugged America. Disneyland's next edition was in Tomorrowland, the Flying Saucers. It was a day for celebration when the square rigger Columbia was added to Disneyland's fleet. She was from an earlier era than the Mark Twain. The Columbia is a replica of the first American ship to circumnavigate the globe. Her commission was signed by George Washington in 1787. She left Boston and returned nearly 3 years later after having logged 41,000 plus miles. Our Columbia has already traveled half that far on the Frontierland River. Exciting. These are man-made rapids and real live Indians. Every kid has had dreams of living in a treehouse, and the Swiss Family Robinson treehouse probably tops those dreams. stars the talented Mills family, Mary, daughter Haley, and John, who played the role of the father in the film. Swiss Family Robinson family lived in a very unusual home because it was furnished with things they salvaged from the shipwreck. Some of the furnishings, like the organ, were unusual for a ship, let alone a treehouse. System was unusual too. It took a lot of ingenuity to get running water to the top of the treehouse. One of the advantages of living in a treehouse is the wonderful view. Over there is the Frontierland River. And from the back porch, you can see the launches on the Jungleland River as they enter the rainforest. The animal population of our jungle has grown. We started with 2 elephants, and now we have quite a family, 43 and a half to be exact. The late Prime Minister Nehru felt at home with the Indian elephants. Addition to the Jungleland cruise is the African veldt area. Here the animals are gathering around watching the lions who have just made a kill. Around the next bend of the river is the Trap Safari. They're really up a tree. The laughing hyenas at last have something to laugh at.
Ah, aloha. It is showtime now in Walt Disney's Enchanted Tiki Room.
Julie, I think you know our fine feathered friend here, Jose, the host of the Enchanted Tiki Room at Disneyland.
Yes, I've seen him many times there.
Jose, Julie's been selected to represent Disneyland as Miss Tencenio. Do you approve?
Thank you, Jose.
Buenos dias, senorita.
You know, the same scientific equipment that guides rockets to the moon is used to make Jose and his little friends in the tiki room sing, talk, move, and practically think for themselves. And I guess you could call him a creature of the space age. But why don't we let Jose speak for himself down at Disneyland? Show the folks what goes on behind the scenes.
Buenos dias, senor and senoritas. How do you do down there? Ah, aloha. It is showtime now in Walt Disney's enchanted tiki room. Hurry, hurry to tiki room. Tikis make drum go boom. Magic is happening. All the birds and flowers sing. Better come see this thing. Walt Disney's enchanted tiki room. Come to the tiki room. Hurry to the tiki room. Now, friends, before we see the show, I take you behind the scene for a few moments. The whole show runs from this room. That fellow is Troubleshooter. He is the electric engineer, also a veterinarian for all the tiki room actors. Maybe we'd like to see how everything works, okay? Water power here goes through the pipes and runs the magic fountain. Here is the air system, pump the air for the lifelike movement. Here is now the electric power. This is the big boss. He directs everything. Brain of big boss is here. It is called programmer. Inside is running the tape. It tells us when to talk, sing, and even to breathe. This is muscle assisting all kinds of relays on this panel. They make the cockatoo head turn left and right, make the flower to open and the tiki god sing. And here is special thing to make coffee. Come now to other side. It is easy to understand. Audio AC rectified to pulsating DC. Drives a solenoid in the bird beaks, a flower mouse, and the etc. in the cho. The flashing light means everything is going A-OK. The buzzer. Uh-oh. The show is going to start. Come along, amigos. You got to find a good seat.
Jose, wake up. It's showtime.
Oh, buenos dias, senorita. My siestas are getting shorter and shorter. Oh, look at all the people. And welcome to Walt Disney's Enchanted Tiki Room. Hey, Michael, mi amigo, pay attention, it's showtime.
So it is. And what darling people I have sitting under me. Pierre, you rascal, you. Let's put on the show.
Mon ami, I am always ready, as you say, to put on the show. Oh, pardon, madame. That whistle was for my good friend, Fritz.
Ach, du lieber, I almost fell out of mine upper perch.
Mein goodness, you're all staring at us. We better start the show rolling.
Wait, wait. We forgot to wake up the glee club.
Olé, olé, it's show time.
In the tiki 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 room, in the tiki 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 room,
all the birds sing words and the flowers croon.
In the tiki 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 room,
our magnificent production is yet to come. So strum the guitar and beat the drum. We've been a hit and we know you adore us. So come on and join us in another chorus.
In the tiki 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 room, in the tiki 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 room,
all the birds sing words and the flowers croon.
Dinky, 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 dinky room.
Be careful, me fine friends. The gods have been angered by all the celebrating. But, me buckos, every cloud has a silver lining.
Monsieur and Madame, we hope you will always remember the amazing things which happened here in Walt Disney's enchanted tiki room.
As night falls, a new kind of magic takes over in Disneyland.
We'll be right back.
thanks to the summer season, it has become a tradition to hold our Dixieland at Disneyland celebration on the Big River. Great Dixieland musicians from all over the country come to take part in this big event.
Julie, you've been briefed on our plans for the future, and I see you're ready now to take off.
Yes, Walt, and I'm looking forward to meeting some of you personally.
Well, good luck and happy landings, Julie.
Thank you, Walt. Bye-bye.
Goodbye. Julie's on her way for a year of travel, but we'll be back in a minute to tell you about our next program. Just hold it.
On our next program, Injustice and Tyranny spark the action of that great adventure known as the Boston Tea Party. And a young lad named Johnny Tremaine plays an important role in the budding struggle for human liberty.
But I'm a nobody.
And we're all nobodies when we're standing alone.
It's what I tried to tell you, Johnny. It's when we fight together that counts.
And we happen to believe that we must fight just as fiercely against small tyrannies as against big ones.
Seems as though everybody in Boston's interested in tea.
Not tea, Johnny. The principle behind it.
This meeting can do nothing more to save the country.
Come on, lad.
It's a tall old tree and a strong old tree. And we are the sons, yes, we are the sons of liberty.
Relive those stirring events that have long inspired freedom-loving people everywhere. Join Johnny Tremaine and all the Sons of Liberty for the Boston Tea Party on Walt Disney's Wonderful World of Color.